Hey everyone, welcome back to a new video. I hope you had a great day. Let's take a look at some new malicious compliance stories, where people comply to the letter, but not the spirit of a request. The first story is called Business as Usual. I had worked at a small and rural internet company for nearly 6 years. It was family owned, and they paid us all really well for the work that we did. Barely anyone ever left the company. In my position, I was head of sales, and I controlled all software that was associated with clients. This had everything in it, including billing addresses, service addresses, and leads for new clients. It was an outdated program for sure, but it got the job done and it worked for us. Fast forward a time, and we are still doing our regular jobs when there was an unscheduled meeting thrown at us. We walked in, and there were several new faces sitting on the other end of the table. They announced that they had sold the company to XYZ. XYZ seemed like an okay place to continue working, because they too were local and the team seemed nice. I was told everything is business as usual and to not do anything different. The transition took place, and ever so often, someone from the new company would come to me and ask how we would do things and get a feel for it. I could tell they were trying to read us out, so I went balls to the wall with renewals on old accounts. They announced to me that I needed to go to the HR department around closing time. Having anticipated this, I saved all of my commission files and emailed them to myself. I ran to the office, and they laid me off on the spot because they do not pay commissions to their staff. I said okay, and that I plan on them still paying me my commissions for the time I was there, as they had not discussed anything pay related with me yet. She said again, we do not pay commissions. I emailed my commission statement to the manager I was working with, and basically was told the same thing. Fast forward to the next week, when they realized they no longer had the credentials to get into our system, and they called to ask for the information. I let them know that I would be happy to do that when I come up there to get my check for commission. I did not hear anything the next day, and then I get a call that my commission check is in the office. I went up there, grabbed the biggest commission check I have ever made, and gave them the credentials. Never tell someone business as usual when you do not intend on things being business as usual. The next story is called Entitled Neighbor. So, a few years back, I, 20 male, had a small two-room flat in a very old building in which you could hear everything. My bedroom was right next to the wall of my neighbor's flat. He was a stupid lunatic who always played video games until 4 or 5 AM, and he had some kind of problem with losing in them. So, every time he would lose, he would start screaming, throwing things around and punching the wall, waking me up almost every night. At the time, I was doing two jobs and needed every second of sleep I could get. I tried talking to him on several occasions, but nothing helped. One time, when I was out for work, I even left my sound system running a mix of artillery and machine gun barrage, just to show him how annoying this stuff could be. But, as entitled people are, it didn't do any good. Fast forward a few months and nothing improved, and I was getting crazy over this. One Saturday night, I had a little poker game running in my flat with a few friends, and my neighbor was having one of his usual tantrums. Since I had guests and they didn't want to listen to him, we turned up the music. Everybody listened to something different, so there was a good mix of metal, techno, industrial, and hardcore. My neighbor was furious at some point and apparently called the police to file a noise complaint. Luckily, when they pulled up, one of my guys saw them driving up as he was out for a quick cigarette. Now comes the fun. We turned the music down before they came up. So, when they rang the doorbell and I opened, they could not hear anything noisy, just a few guys having some beer and a little poker game. They told us that there was a noise complaint from a neighbor, saying it was too loud and that this was something constant. We told them we've been like this for hours. Then I had a genius idea. I asked them if my neighbor called them, which of course they couldn't answer, but I knew it was him. So I invited the two cops in and told them I'd show them what a real noise disturbance looked like. I led them to my bedroom, where they could still hear my neighbor throwing tantrums, and I told the cops the whole story. And since they were already here, that I would like to file a noise complaint against him. The cops were shocked at the noise you could hear from the other flat and went directly over to his flat to tell him to shut the hell up. I had a huge laugh as the cops came back to tell me to call them when he did something like this again, because in that case I would be able to file charges. I never slept better than that night, and finally I had some peace at home. The third story is called Staff is Replaceable. About 2 years ago, I was working as an assistant manager at a small business with about 20 to 25 employees overall. I had been there for about 5.5 years, 3 as an entry-level position. When the business grew, the manager was getting overwhelmed. So they created the assistant manager position and put me in it. Now, I was their jack of all trades, covering multiple positions in the business when needed. I built and maintained a new website. The old one had not been updated in several years. I also served as the entire IT department and got a new phone system installed, along with replacing another major critical piece of equipment. And I was also responsible for inventory management, distributor relationships, and more. Well, owner number one was fed up with owner number two's BS. Owner number one was the responsible one that knew what was going on. Number two was just along for the ride. He said, either send me your half or buy my half. Well, number two ended up choosing to stay. A few staff left because of this, including the manager, while the rest of us braced for the disaster that was coming while we decided what to do. On to the malicious compliance. As assistant manager, the staff had brought up some concerns about quality and staff safety to me, so I brought them to the owner. The response I got was, I don't care about staff concerns, they are all replaceable anyway. I was also told to tell the staff they should no longer bring their concerns to me, but to the new manager. It was her hire that had been there 2 weeks and no one trusted yet. Well, I went home that night, shared the entire conversation with most of the staff, and typed up my 2 weeks notice. The handbook said 4 weeks required, but I refused to work for her longer than 2 weeks more. And I turned it in the next morning. The fallout. In addition to losing me and everything I normally did, I had also taken over scheduling since we were short-staffed and the new manager didn't know the staff yet and what we needed. Another 3 to 4 people quit over the next month. This left the owner overall with about 50% of the staff that the place needed, and even at full staffing we were barely managing. The website has not been touched since I left, still has the old owner and other outdated information up. I've gotten multiple questions about where something was or how to do something because no one else knows how to run certain things. A number of the clients I know have left because things have been getting worse in their product. Overall, I give it a couple of years before she has to sell or close, because I can't imagine it is going to go well. The last story is called Manager thinks she can mess with the best people on her team. I used to work for a large team with like 25 staffers, 6 supervisors, a manager and a director. The manager was a blonde woman in her mid-30s, whose only discernible qualification was being an attractive blonde woman in her mid-30s. The team was going through a transition from having old-timers retire and hiring new staff. So for the first year and a half, I don't think we ever left on time. Overtime was pretty much a given. But towards the end of our second year, my buddy and I, we started the same day, noticed things are slowing down. We were catching up on the workloads and people are starting to leave on time. One day, we finish all of our work, help out a few other teammates finish their work, and get pulled into an office with the director to get some praise and recognition. On cloud 9, we get back to our desk, pack up, and leave a few minutes early, feeling good about our solid day's work. We got written up. The next day, we got chewed out by the manager. She reminded us of our start and end times. You are hourly, and your shift starts at 8 and ends at 9. You can't leave early just because you feel like it. We received a lengthy diatribe about being a team player and staying until the work is done, blah blah blah. It was unfortunate timing, because the reason the director has pulled us into a meeting the day before was to congratulate us on our hard work. Turns out that management had done some metrics testing and figured out that 2 people on a team of 25 individual contributors were doing about 12% of the total work done, each. So the 2 of us were doing a quarter of the work of the entire team. Our manager had not yet been privy to that knowledge. Armed with the knowledge that everyone was liking their work to last the full day, we decided that for the next month we would both work at the pace of everyone else. And we would be at our desk at 8 and wouldn't leave till 5. Most days we were done about an hour early and then twiddled our thumbs looking at blank screens from about 4:30 till 5. We even stayed a few minutes past 5. About 3 weeks in, our manager even commends us on our hard work. About 2 weeks later, that month's matrix results came in and numbers were down. Turns out we were now doing about the same as everyone else, and the team was not hitting its figures. Our manager had to have known what we were doing, but what was she going to say? They aren't picking up everyone else's slack anymore. She tried to screw us over another way. I was a few minutes late one day. She woke me up. Mind you, some of her supervisors would show up late on a daily basis, but I'm cool with that long haul revenge. I started to show up early and would sit at my desk with the computer screen still locked until exactly 8 a.m. This went on for about a week, before the director had had enough and came up to my desk and asked me what I was doing. I explained that my manager wrote me up for leaving a few minutes early and wrote me up for being a few minutes late. So I'm just making sure I'm never late, as she explained to me that I'm hourly and my shift starts at 8. I don't know if he thought the offices were soundproof or just didn't care. But the reaming he gave her was like listening to a heavy metal concert. And now it's your time to shine. Let me know what you think about the stories. On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you rate the stories and today's video? Thank you for subscribing to the channel and for hitting the like button. If you haven't already, why don't you make this the video that you subscribe to the channel? And please don't forget to hit the like button for the algorithm. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you have a great day. Stay safe. Bye bye.